was the summer I turned 18. We lived in a one-room run-down shack on the outskirts of New Orleans. We didn't have money for food or rent, at least we were hard-pressed. The mama spent every last penny we had to buy me a dancing dress. Mama washed and combed and curled my hair, and she painted my eyes and lips. Then I stepped into a satin dancing dress that had split on the side clean up to my hip. It was red velvet trim and it fit me good. Standing back from the looking glass, there's the woman where a half-grown kid had stood. She said, "Here's your watch, it's fancy, don't let me down." She said, "Here's your watch, it's fancy, don't let me down." Mama dabbed a little bit of perfume on my neck, then she kissed my cheek. Then I saw the tears welling up in her troubled eyes as she started to speak. She looked at a pitiful shack and then she looked at me and took a ragged breath. She said, "Your paw's run off and I'm real sick and the baby's gonna starve to death." She handed me a heart-shaped locket that said that I don't sell but you. And I shivered as I watched a roach crawl across the toe of my high-heel shoe. Sounded like somebody else was talking, asking Mama what do I do. "Just be nice to the gentleman fans and they'll be nice to you." She said, "Here's your one chance, fancy, don't let me down. Here's your one chance, fancy, don't let me down. Lord, forgive me for what I do. But if you are that one, it's up to you. Then don't let me down. Now your mom's gonna move you uptown." Well, that was the last time I saw my mom. The night I left that rickety shack, the welfare people came and took the baby. Mama died and I ain't been back. But the wheels of fate started to turn, and for me there was no way out. Wasn't very long till I knew exactly what my mama had been talking about. I knew what I had to do and I made myself this solemn vow that I was gonna be a lady someday, though I didn't know when or how. But I could have seen spinning the rest of my life with my head on down in shame. You know I might have been born just for laying white trash, but fancy was my name. "Here's your one chance, fancy, don't let me down." "Here's your one chance, fancy, don't let me down." Wasn't very long after my benevolent man took me on and off the streets. 1 week later I was pouring his tea in a five-room hotel suite. I charmed a king, a congressman, an occasional aristocrat. Then I got me a Georgia mansion and an elegant New York house flat. And I ain't a man. Now in this world there's a lot of self-righteous hypocrites that call me bad. Criticize mama and turning me out, no matter how little we had. But I ain't really had to worry about nothing for 9 or 15 years. I can still hear the desperation.